Rainbow color schemes could be hurting your map. What can you use instead? Hi, I'm Heather, and I'm a cartographer. In this video, I'll talk about quantitative color schemes. Rainbow color schemes are really popular in maps because they look so good. I think there's also a belief that they can show more detailed information because there's so much variation between this end of the scheme and this one. At least that's what I used to think. Unfortunately, rainbow color schemes just don't work very well when communicating quantitative data. First, there's the fact that many people are colorblind, or rather, they perceive colors differently than I do. So, rainbow color schemes are going to be pretty difficult for them to interpret correctly. But even if we all perceived colors in exactly the same way, I'd still be discouraging you from these kinds of maps. A rainbow color scheme moves through various hues, and different hues behave differently. Red is really attention-grabbing, yellow is always very light, blues and purples tend to be dark. So as you move from hue to hue, you end up with bands that are darker, lighter, and more attention-grabbing than others. This really messes with how people interpret the map. If you're mapping quantitative data, you're trying to show that some places have more of something and others have less. Quantity is more clearly understood with a color's value, its lightness or darkness, rather than its hue. A color can have more or less value, but it can't have more or less hue. It can just have different kinds of hue. So if you're mapping different kinds of things, use hue. Rainbows are great for mapping qualitative data. But if you're mapping more or less of something, use value. Value is great for mapping quantitative data. Here's some examples of value-based color schemes. They all move from light to dark or dark to light. The simplest ones have just one hue, light green to dark green, but you can get a bit fancier by going from light yellow to dark green or dark red to light purple. And if you really miss having all those colors, there's still options for you. There are a number of carefully designed color schemes in ArcGIS Pro and ArcGIS Online that move evenly from a light color to a dark one and still have lots of hues. All of these schemes that I just showed are great alternatives to rainbow color schemes. If you want to test how well a color scheme moves from light to dark, take a picture of it and convert it to black and white. Here I'm using a color vision simulator set to monochrome. In the simulator, I can see that these two colors have almost the same value. So I'll go back to ArcGIS Pro and choose a lighter yellow. I'll test this new scheme in the simulator as well. Now moves evenly from dark to light. So if you're mapping quantitative data, more or less of something, stay away from rainbow color schemes. Instead, choose schemes that move evenly from light to dark.